Sleeping at high altitude is one of the biggest challenges on major climbs like Aconcagua. To get a head start, we used a Hypoxico altitude tent to pre-acclimatize before even leaving home. In this video, we'll show you how we tracked our sleeping adaptation step by step using this Excel tracker and why it made a huge difference for us at high camps. At high altitudes, oxygen is much thinner, making sleep extremely difficult. Poor sleep can quickly lead to fatigue, altitude sickness, and even force climbers to abandon their summit attempts. Pre-acclimatizing by sleeping in an altitude tent trains your body to adapt slowly and safely. To keep things organized, we created a simple but detailed Excel sheet to track our daily progress. Let's walk through each column and how we used it to adjust our sleeping plan. First, we track the date for each night we slept inside the altitude tent. Tracking daily helped us stay consistent and notice patterns like whether our sleep quality dipped at certain altitudes. Next is the tent altitude setting. We started at 5,000 feet and aimed to increase the altitude by 500 feet per night if sleep quality allowed. However, if we didn't sleep well, we stayed at the same altitude an extra night until our body adjusted. This is a subjective score where we rated each night's sleep from 1 very poor to 5 excellent. It helped us quickly see whether our body was adapting. A lower score told us to be cautious and not ascend altitude settings too quickly. In this column, we counted how many times we woke up during the night. Frequent wake-ups usually indicated struggling to breathe or feeling overheated inside the tent, or sometimes we need to check the oxygen. This was another important metric alongside oxygen readings to assess real adaptation progress. Finally, we kept open notes for each night. Things like woke up with mild headache, dry mouth, or slept well helped us track symptoms that numbers alone couldn't explain. Here are some tips we learned the hard way while using the altitude tent. Starting around 5,000 feet is safe even if you feel strong. It's better to start easier and build confidence. If you had poor sleep, stay at the same altitude for 2-3 nights before going higher. Rushing adaptation can backfire fast. The tent holds in a lot of heat even in winter. We slept with light blankets and cracked windows open if needed. Altitude dehydrates you faster, even while sleeping. We kept 2 liters of water nearby and took a few sips during wake-ups. While we didn't have a handy monitor, setting alarms every 3-4 hours to manually check our oxygen helped catch problems early. Sleeping in the tent isn't always comfortable, but the real goal is helping your body adapt. Some rough nights are part of the process. This preparation made a huge difference once we reached Camp 2 and Camp 3 on Aconcagua. While many climbers struggled with severe altitude sickness, we slept better, recovered faster, and avoided the worst symptoms thanks to our gradual, careful pre-acclimatization. If you're planning a high-altitude expedition, we highly recommend using an altitude tent and tracking your progress like this. It gives you a major advantage before you even step on the mountain. If you found this helpful, like the video. Please subscribe for more real-world training tips and climbing adventures. And drop a comment if you have questions about setting up your own altitude tent training.